Europe to St. Louis, Missouri, of all places, to do a musical performance was unheard of.
Especially in 1851. So when an international singing star known as the Swedish Nightingale came to town to perform, it was a sensation. Her name was Jenny Lind, and she was convinced to tour America by another show business sensation who offered to promote her concerts.
She had linked up with, of all people, P.T. Barnum, who of course was one of the great promoters, hucksters, circus developers, museum developers of the early 19th century, but he was also a promoter of the first class.
Jenny Lind arrived in St. Louis on the steamboat Lexington and made the Planters Hotel her home, where local choral groups would show up to serenade her. Her concerts were across the street at Wyman's Hall.
They charged what was a really substantial price for that time, 1851. They charged $5 to get in to see Jenny Lind sing and $4 for standing room.
Jenny Lind played St. Louis for six glorious nights, never to return again. Though in 1933, the Muni performed a popular musical based on the life of Jenny Lind. It was called The Nightingale.
In 1851, people didn't get around much. And so the idea that this world-renowned celebrity would come to St. Louis was really astounding.
As a way to whip up even more of a frenzy, Barnum held back a number of tickets to be auctioned each day before the performance. And in typical Barnum style, he charged 10 cents admission just for the chance to bid. But apparently, along with smarts, Barnum also had a heart, giving the money raised by that door charge to local charities.